Good morning, everyone. This is Julie McDonald with Microcomp Technologies, and I'd like to thank all of you for attending today's webinar with Fanville. Today's host is Tommy Lee. He is their Vice President of Sales in North America, and he'll be presenting. If anyone has any questions, please submit them in the question box, and Tommy will answer them at the end of today's presentation. Tommy, thank you so much for being with us again today. I am finished for now. Please go ahead and take it on over.
I appreciate the great introduction, Julie. Thank you very much. And welcome, everybody, to this webinar. I'm going to go over several things today. The agenda for today is, as everybody knows, and those that are new, we develop SIP endpoint solutions. And I intend to kind of do sort of a high-level overview about our entire spectrum. And if you want to dig a little bit deeper to anyone, feel free to address that in the question box, because I'll go ahead and stay behind as long as necessary to kind of do a deeper dive in any one particular solution. And in addition to some of the things that I'm going to show, I would also reveal some of the new routes that we're going to go and kind of give you an idea on what we're going to be introducing in 2023. I'll cap it off at the end of this webinar to kind of highlight the different promotions that we're putting together, so that if those are interested, you know, we got some promotions going on that'll expire at the end of March. So keep an eye for it. And if you need a soft copy of the solution, what I can do is I can create a PDF of it and I'll send it over to Julie, and feel free to talk to her, or you can contact me. You know, my name is tommy.lee@fanville.com, or you can contact Julie. I'll get you a PDF version of this in case you need it for your reference. So with that said, I'll go ahead and move on to my first slide. And again, thank you very much for your time. When I talked earlier about the solution spectrum, you could basically divide our product category, the product solutions, into several categories. First and foremost is our SIP business phones. Just a little bit of a background. Fanville's been around for about 20 years this year. And you could actually... And we actually divide our business into several things. We not only are we a manufacturer of our own solutions, but we're also a big manufacture our own brand as well. And you could divide our SIP business phones into several categories. We have one, which is the business phones. I'll go ahead and highlight with a laser pointer here on the different solutions that we have. So these are our business phones. And many of the different series that we're going to have, we're going to go through. And I'm just going to touch on the highlighted points and how we differentiate against the other solutions as well. Beyond that, I also want to highlight next to it, we also have a specialized line for just hospitality solutions, what we call hotel phones. And then we have a whole line outlining hotel phones. And to the third of it that we're going to be introducing as well from the third phone is, we also introduced a product called a wireless phone, which is introduced by Linkville. Many people may not be aware of this, but Linkville is a sub-brand of Fanville, and that's going to focus purely on a full spectrum of wireless solutions. You know, why do we do a sub-brand? I think, you know, we realize that many solutions out there is very difficult to keep track of all the different acronyms of remembering all the X's, the U's, the V's, and the T's and stuff like that. So we came up with a sub-brand of Fanville that we're calling Linkville. And this is the first product that we're going to introduce that's going to be a wireless phone. And I'll just talk a little bit about that in a future slide. That aside, we also have our SIP door, intercom, and public access solutions here, which really outline our security products. And it really stretches from intercoms that I'm outlining here. We have both indoor intercoms as well as outdoor ruggedized intercoms with and without cameras. So really it's up to you and how you want to choose that. Besides that, we're also focusing on door security, of which we're going to have several different models, of which ranging from one button to several buttons to a full keypad that's going to couple with a video as well as an RFID card access. So that's on the outside, but even on the inside, we actually developed some panels that have been specialized to go ahead and not read only our video, but also video from third-party cameras as well. So that the idea here is not to necessarily have one of our phones that support video hanging on the wall, but you could also support a flat screen monitor that will give you the full or enlarged display without necessarily having associated with a phone, And you'll also have speakerphone capabilities, giving you one button access on the phone itself, on the indoor access stations, or without. So we have a whole several models that'll really suit your needs. And last but not least, we also have a very popular model called public broadcasting. And what this does is really serves as a offering a SIP engine that allows you to assign a SIP extension to almost any analog interface. The most popular one is really tying this into a PA system, which is hooked into an analog amplifier. And you could actually use this gateway to assign that analog amplifier a SIP extension. And the great news about all of these solutions I'm talking about is you can really tie them all together without device management system that's based in the cloud. This is a tool, that we provide to our partners free of charge so that you can go ahead and monitor and upload and download specific configurations that'll meet your needs. So with that said, let me just kind of dig a little bit deeper in our phone solution. As I mentioned earlier, we have the V-Series, which was just introduced, coupled with our core models, which is the XU and X-Series. When I came on board in Fanville, the X and XU series was just being introduced and has really become a core solution in terms of phones. And early in the year, last year, we actually introduced the V-Series. And from a functionality perspective, the best way to really look at the V-Series is not only a different design, but also it incorporates Wi-Fi as well as Bluetooth on the actual phone itself, versus on the XU series, if you needed integrated Bluetooth, you can go ahead and actually support that with the dongle. Of course, some of these phones in the upper hand here support Bluetooth internal to the phone, as well as all of these above. But if you want a more integrated solution, I would seriously consider the Vs on top of that. And of course, down below, we have the H series phones, which comes in two different colors and several different styles to sort of match, mix and match what you're looking for too. One of the things we're finding out is this with this thin phone, this is sort of a retro 1970s narrowband phone that is really a low real estate demanding two line SIP phone where you could actually just pick up the line and really just be able to provide the ability to offer a two line phone under a classic narrowband phone, which has really gained a lot of popularity outside of hospitality, but into many of the different homes and offices that don't necessarily have the real estate to host a phone. Now let's dig a little bit deeper, because this is a new series. In terms of the Wi-Fi capability, this supports both dual band 2.4 as well as the 5 gigahertz band, and provides support for Bluetooth 4.2 in terms of the different wireless capabilities. There is absolutely no feature that you can look for that these series will not touch. But in addition to having low, medium to high, as well as an Android model here, we want to make sure that even if you decide to adopt the V-Series, that we actually have a V62, which also addresses the cost-effective line. Because we realize that when you deploy in an office building, you have not only, you know, medium to large size phones, but you also have economic phones that really provide, you know, sort of a cafe phone or people that really use phone operations for its baseline usage. And all of these things can be done. And some of the niceties about the 67 and the 65, we also put antibacterial plastics as well, because we realize that some organizations have a shared desk phone, and we provide whatever we can. This is some of the technology that you can use to sort of help resolve some of the paranoia of germaphobe that has become the post-pandemic ways. And another of enhancements as well is it supports six-party asynchronous audio conferencing. So what this means is that internal to the phone, for those who need to support conferencing, you could actually bring in you yourself plus five other people. In the older type phones, you could only do, you know, up to three. So this is a great enhancement. This is a matrix in which I'm going to go ahead. I'm not going to get into the details, but where we actually stand out against a lot of the competition is highlighted with the red stars. I'm not going to go over this piece by piece, but this is available for your soft reference. If you want a soft copy, just let me know. But when you look at the Wi-Fi, the PoE, the color screen, all of these things are really supported across the board, in addition to providing any camera. The good news about the 67, it actually includes a camera that's actually on the display, which is tiltable, that you can go ahead and configure for those who want dual band, dual type of phones, you know, for extended usage. Some of our XU series, the XU series phones is really known for its buttons. And the feedback that we get very often is that the layout of these buttons is really ideal for those who really like to choose a design that mimics many of the legacy phones out there. For those that are really uplifting a Panasonic or an NEC phone, you'll notice that many people have the up and down BLFs or call waiting keys on the side. But the great news is that we've developed on the XU series side keys on the display, which allows you to not only manage which SIP extension or park keys that you're doing here, but you can do that without necessarily disturbing the BLF keys that are on the side. And it's something that Fanville really introduced to the marketplace, having dual color screens and also giving you separate windows in case you need more buttons. You can use this button to go ahead and do that as well. And obviously some of the high level descriptions that we have here are outlined below for your reference. You know, this is just another talk about the different key loads in the X6U, which is our flagship XU product, which really you could almost use this for someone who works at the front desk and that needs a lot of keys, but don't necessarily want to complicate it under an extension board, because when you have three times these keys, that gives more than enough buttons that a lot of people can use. Plus, in addition, you can use these side keys as well to sort of manage all the different extensions that you do. Another nice feature as well is that Fanville also supports all their phones with a two-year warranty. So by the time, you know, the installer puts in your phone, you could also, we'll also support that for 2 years versus many of the competition supports only one. A nice thing for those who actually have a decent demand, we could also, instead of providing Fanville as a brand, we also have a phone set that you can provide your own logo. I'm not going to talk about this because I could spend a whole webinar talking about our customized products. But what you can do is that if you have the ability of placing a minimum order quantity of 200, then we can go ahead and talk, have a discussion about putting your own logo so that you can go ahead and buy a neutral phone and we'll give you this basically plaque that gives you the ability to put your own logo versus Fanville, and that this comes across as being your technology as well. Now let's look at this new series that we just introduced. I talked about the XU series, which ranges from the X3U, 4, 5, and 6. Now what we've done, what you might see in our website, is we came out with a whole brand new X300 family. Now the unit that I want to focus on is this unit right here, because what we've done is we realize that there are cost-effective solutions that people are looking for, a less expensive phone with basic features. But what I want to point out is that we actually integrated Wi-Fi features on the X303W, which I think highlights that one model above and beyond the rest, because with this, we were able to offer a more basic phone that has inclusion of Wi-Fi internally. This is great for those people who want to go ahead and expand and provide a phone into the Wi-Fi environment, perhaps for a home use. As you know, very often businesses throughout America as well as Canada, a lot of people are working from home part-time and going to work full part-time as well, but they need a Wi-Fi access to go ahead and do that, and it could be done with a very basic phone that does this here as well. So something for your consideration on the new X300 series. This is a little bit of an explosion of some of the things that we've done, where now it supports both 2.4 and 5 gigahertz lines, where you offer a color screen and all the basic capabilities, but this gives the ability to provide those calls from a single phone at a much lower price than the XU series, in case you needed something that matches that type of capability. One of the things I wanted to show you is the X210. One of the unique things about Fanville is that our design doesn't necessarily lend to sidecars. And what we've done is that anybody who's looking for a front desk phone or a control phone could look at it in one single button. So for those who really like phones, we actually integrated the sidecar as well as the phone onto one motherboard. And what this allows is very simple implementation. You don't have to deal with two firmware downloads along with a connection cable, etc. So this works as one single phone with all of these capabilities across three separate lines. And that's what we do to really address those unique functionalities or the unique requirements for lots of buttons to address those needs in the front desk or in a control tower. Because with the X210, you could also use our display to display video on our front access units as well as our intercoms. So you can see who's going to be accessed out there and assign one of these keys that you can press to go ahead and open those doors for that person if they're friendly. Outside of that, this is just an exploded view of our hospitality model available in two separate colors. We have some of these in the H2U model, which is available in both black and white. And also the classic models as well as with the H3 black and white. And this comes with the classic customized template where the Marriott, the Holiday Inns can come in, have their logo put on the phone. And so you have a customized hardware template. Now, for those who want to take it one little step taller, we have the H5W, which is also Wi-Fi capable, that gives the integrator or the installer the ability to go ahead and upgrade and provide a bitmap image of it, of the actual logo and addresses, so that you don't have to wait for the faceplate. This gives them a lot of features because you can have these phones in stock, but without the faceplate, you can't necessarily deploy it, and you're able to do that with the H5W. So the idea here is providing you the flexible tools at the end to go ahead and meet your specific requirements. I talked a little bit about the Linkville Wi-Fi phone, and this is an exploded capabilities, but the great news about this is that it could support 8 hours of talk time coupled with 220 hours of standby. This is great because it also supports Wi-Fi 6, which gives really the strength of a Wi-Fi phone that's pretty much at par a lot with a lot of the other alternative technologies such as DECT and everything. And we see that as a great vehicle to go ahead and start making Wi-Fi phones overcome many of the legacy troubles that it had in the past and providing you with really a ruggedized phone here. Now, some of the other nice things I can't show with this thing, but with the quick one click of these side buttons, it actually comes up with function keys. So that whether you click to the right or to the left, you'll actually have 6 function keys that you can choose from to go ahead and pick that, because we heard that design because many people say, you know, when I have this portable Snicker-like phone, I can't necessarily dial all these different people. Now with a click of a key, you can have the portability of a Snicker bar phone while also addressing any specific speed dials you have with 2 separate pages, both left click and right click as well. So these are all supported as well, and you can also roam around with whatever Wi-Fi network that you have intended for it. Now let's move on to the access and intercom security and PA public announcement broadcasting systems. Starting off with our PA2S, the difference between the PA2S and the PA3 is that the PA2S, it really integrates a relay function in it so that if you have a gate or a switch that you want to go ahead and control, you could use the PA2S. But those who are strictly concentrating on just audio only, we have a PA3 version that allows you to just focus in on audio, and it gives you the capabilities of storing audio files on memory cards so that you can have things like maybe music playing in the background stored on it, and that's something that the actual device can do. This gives you sort of a quick high-level overview about what you can actually do. You can have something that goes across, starting with a remote control unit, going across the cloud, and then you could have this PA3 serving as a multicast device, streaming audio across all the internet if you want to, and whatever device that's listening on the other side can also do that as well. This also works with the PA2 as well, but the PA2 just gives you that slight relay addition to kind of bring that functionality to you if you need it. Just a reference to kind of give you an idea of the difference between the two models for those that are interested in our PA system. And these things are readily available through distribution today. Now let's talk about our door access units. This is in the security space, of which has gotten great reception. We've actually have these units that actually have a peripheral sensor so that if you decide to show up close to these sensors, they'll actually turn on automatically and wait for your specific input. All of these have cameras as well that you can use that will display on our phones as well as any device that handles an H.264 codec. These are all WeGAN and ONVIF standardized protocol support. And we have some of the legacy I3 series that provide different type of atmospheres as well. All these provide great access, SIP endpoints that give you this total reach as well. In addition to that, we also have intercoms for real simple emergency applications. Here, the real decision here is you want to either apply it to indoor or outdoor intercoms. And the primary difference between the two is the ruggedization of the external skeleton that basically protects all of the hardware internally. And we have it in several different models with and without video in both scenarios. Beyond the outdoor units, we have indoor units, which is sort of a flat screen. Not only will it look good inside your residence, but also even commercially, this is something you could either perhaps mount on your desk or mount on a wall that you can see who's at the door without necessarily taking up much real estate. It has integrated Wi-Fi, as well as giving you the capability of seeing who's at the door. You could tell whether they're a FedEx person, a delivery pizza person, or perhaps somebody you don't necessarily want to answer the door for. So these are the things that provide capabilities on the indoor. This is just a quick process view of what ends up happening when you look at a person could be delivering boxes. You see the person in the outdoor, and you can really provide remote control on the one central location. Some of the different models that we have, some that include buttons as well and some that don't. This is just a quick snapshot of all the series that we have. Both of these that you see in front of you are Android-based, but we also have more simplified Linux-based solutions that can provide you with touch screens, as well as some basic models that just have 5 buttons. So any particular model that you're looking for, you can go ahead and use this as well. Aside from being just an indoor station, some people like to use these displays to display emergency type notifications in hallways and monitors and things like that. They could also serve that function too to deliver whatever messages that you want to send throughout the campus or the building. Here's an example on the next screen. We have some of the more Android-based models here and then coupled with some of the Linux-based models here for your particular reference. Why Fanville? I mean, Fanville does not develop an engine. We actually build endpoints and endpoints only. So as a result, we devote lots of resources to be compatible with a ever-growing list that you see here that we make sure that we're fully compatible or auto-provisionable through most of the major platforms here. And the idea here is that if they don't necessarily support the unit, you could also couple that with our FDMCS, which is our device control management system, tying all of these systems, or at least some of the systems that aren't necessarily on the PBX's provisioning server, you could use our unit to go ahead and supplement that and to give you sort of a central management system. One of the things I don't recommend is to have two provisioning services on the same model. That creates a lot of conflict because each model is trying to fight for control over it, but it's great in being able to fill in whatever gaps that one may not cover versus the other. So a lot of the products that we introduce new, it takes a little bit of time for it to register with our third-party commercial switches here, but we could also support that through our system to your right. Now, in terms of new solutions, we've just introduced the CS30, which is really a sort of what we call a laptop enhancement speaker. You know, this is a small speaker solution. And what we find out is that there are many people who are conducting lots and lots of conference calls across their laptop. And what this gives the capability of, instead of being in front of the laptop, this provides 360 degrees of optimized voice communication so that you could put this in the center. And depending on where you sit, you can go ahead and get an optimized audio dual exchange on your laptop. Another new thing that we introduced the first time we're showing at the former IT Expo is a SIP ceiling speaker. This is a great deal. In fact, this also replaces an old black phone that we had in the past. And this is something that we're coming with. This is also armed with a microphone as well. So you can have dual speaker capability as well as an enabled mic capability. Fantastic for a classroom application where you want to have two-way communication amongst all the classes in addition to being able to do just speaker only. But either one of those configurations can be supported, and it also supports the same SIP engine as well with the rest of our SIP endpoints. Now, in terms of promotions and everything like that, we have something for every single family. For those who really like our XU product, we have the ability so that if you purchase 20 of these, you can also couple a free mobile device, or in essence, not a free, but basically a $20 device coupled with that when you want to go and buy 20. In addition to that, we also put together a V-Series, which we became a little more aggressive with. If you buy 10, then you could add on a wireless phone for adding another $10 for it. You couple that with a wireless. The main reason why we do that is because through so many desk phones, there's always a typical requirement for one wireless phone. So we kind of made this bundling or coupling so that you could basically almost pick up a virtually free wireless phone, but it's the Wi-Fi version that I introduced from Linkville in the past. We also do the same for our security as well as access units as well, so that depending on how many i5 and 6 series you buy, we'll provide whatever discounts just based upon, you know, quantities of greater or equal to 20 pieces, if not more. Obviously, you could work through distribution where we have a rebate program so that any of the particular target applications where we have phones as well as pieces here, you may not buy all of one, but if you buy a bunch of PA series coupled with phones as well as other things, or the V series, we'll go ahead and if you do 50 or more, you begin to build up many of the different rebate steps that you can go ahead and have discounts, and our distribution channel will go ahead and pass these discounts on to you. And obviously, last but not least, we have an NFR program, which provides you the ability to go ahead and sample our phones, at a cost price, so that we can bundle basically a high end and a medium end phone on both the V series, the XU series, as well as some of our intercoms and security products as well. And all of these are standard that you can sort of talk to any of our distribution partners moving forward, and we can get you these NFR samples to go ahead and test out our products. That's kind of it of who I have, and I'm providing a whole list of our contact list here. My name is Tommy Lee. My contact information is here, or you could just contact sales@fanville.com. We'll be more than happy to, you know, eventually we'll get the message, but you can send it directly to the team that supports North America right in front of you. So, Julie, that's all that I have for now, and I'll pass the mic back to you.
Thank you so much, Tommy, for that wonderful presentation. And yes, I do have some questions for you. Let's get started with the first one. Here we go.
Thank you.
Will your door security work with other SIP business phones, you know, different brands?
Absolutely. In fact, the whole idea about SIP is that these SIP security products will work with any other particular brands. You know, to give you an analogy about SIP and working with the other brands is that when you go ahead and buy an electrical appliance from a grocery store, nobody thinks about it plugging in. You know, you go into the wall, you can plug it into a wall. Everybody knows that because you go ahead and buy it. SIP in many cases is sort of the electronic version of that electrical plug-in, where there's a standard interface, and as long as the phone itself is SIP compliant, regardless of brands, you should be able to do it. Now, having said that, it depends on what kind of capability. The phones that we have, the screen that we have supports, you know, high resolution H.264 codec. If you have a phone that supports H.264 codec and supporting video, no issues whatsoever. They also support on-VIF standardization as well. So you could not only screen it onto a phone, but you could have it also display on monitors and screens that you would see in banks and casinos as well. So all of these different things are all standardized, and they're not just locked into Fanville phones. Now, Fanville, on the other hand, has these codecs already in many of the top-end phones, so that if you want a phone that supports it, there'll be no questions that our phones would do it. But of course, any other endpoint that has that same capability, you can also see the video as well as the audio capabilities.
Thank you very much, Tommy. Appreciate that. Next question here. Some of the phones have PoE. Do they come with a power adapter, or is that sold separately?
The power adapter is sold separate from all of our phones, because most of our phones are PoE capable, and that except for the really low-end phones, all of the XUs, all of the V series that I showed you are all PoE capable. And if you need a power supply, you would have to buy that as an accessory to our phones.
Excellent. Thank you, Tommy. Next question. No regarding SX business phones, what are the warranties for those devices? For example, the handset has a problem. Will it be a whole phone replacement?
No, actually, we actually have spare parts. In terms of the warranty, there's two parts to your question. The warranty that we have is 2 years, and it basically starts from when basically the integrator provides it into your location. And from there, we basically warrant the phone to operate to specification, so that, you know, we typically have operations, and if something went wrong with it, like the display doesn't work, or if something went wrong with something else that we specify that doesn't support, we will warrant that. Now, in your question about the handsets, sometimes people hold on to our handsets for 5-10 years and says, you know what, this is all mangled. We do sell spare parts, and you can contact our distribution channel to basically get a replacement cord or particular handset that goes with your phone.
Excellent. Thank you, Tommy. Next question here. For the public broadcasting, will any microphone work with any brand?
That's a good question. There is a specific microphone type. One of the idea is that with that, it has to be almost like there's a plug-in module. We actually sell a kit that has sort of an integrated microphone. I don't know it off the top of my head, but there is a mic input that you can put into it that will allow for a third-party mic or any other mic. The safest bet is that Fanville has basically a PA kit that not only provides a microphone, but also provides a switch, a camera, so that you can upgrade whatever project you're doing to make it work with it. I'll give you a classic example. You could take a parking meter that works in the old analog way, and then once you upgrade the audio, what you end up finding is that you could put a camera if you want to, or install a separate button, so that once you push the button, it'll actually make a SIP call to, say, security or the front desk, and they can see who's at the desk and saying, you know what, my hotel key doesn't work, can't you just let us in? And they could just punch a key, and all of a sudden the gate will open up. So that's a quick way of an upgrade, that you can take an old analog parking gate and retrofit it to make it work on the SIP without necessarily having to spend $10,000 for a brand new parking gate.
Thank you for that, Tommy. Next question here. Sure. Regarding the wireless, will any Bluetooth headphone work on that device?
You mean Bluetooth? Well, when you say any, there is probably thousands of different models of it. One of the things that we do have is that there is a compatibility list that we actually done testing with. Now, granted, those are some of the lists that we have on the Bluetooth that we know works with our phones. But we also have, there are many, you could walk into a high tech store and see numerous ones, and I can't guarantee it works hundreds of them, but for the ones that we tested and could provide the list, those will actually work. Beyond the Bluetooth, there are also third-party ones that have sort of an EHS component connector as well, so that many Bluetooth adapters, you can use an EHS connector that will actually have DECT wireless as well. And you can have connections onto our phone that talks to a DECT Bluetooth headset that'll give you a bigger range as well. So all of those are included, but to say that we include all would be a stretch. But some of those that we did test, there are a list that we can provide to the list, but many of the popular ones we do support.
Excellent. Thank you, Tommy. It sounds like it would be good to have that list.
Yep, I can do that.
Excellent. Next question here. Let's see. What is the maximum order quantity, or excuse me, minimum order quantity for phones to be customized?
The minimum order quantity that Fanville states is 200. And if you're willing to order minimum order quantity, that's 200 per model. So say, for example, if you wanted an X4U and you wanted it with your logo on it, just order 200 pieces, send us the logo that you want, and we'll go ahead and develop that little plate that you can replace, and it looks basically like their phone with their logo on it. The great news about that I keep on hearing is that once they see a phone that goes out with that, you know, there's not necessarily a cross, because, you know, the end customer or whoever the provider is, you know, may not be in the phone business, and they could just look at this phone and be able to say, hey, you know, this is XYZ service provider company, and you know, they have a little bit more control about you know, purchasing for that particular endpoint.
Thank you so much, Tommy. Next question here for you.
Mm-hmm.
Are the demo kits entitled for the warranty as well?
You know, I can't see any reason why not. I mean, if you go ahead and buy, that's the first time anybody asked that. But I mean, it is our product. And if you go ahead and purchase demo samples, you know, they're really intended for basically lab use, because many people want to kick it around a lab and to see whether or not they're intended for doing it. But by all means, they are our product. It's something that we support. And frankly, there's no way that we can ID an X4U that was purchased through a sample program versus Burt buying it through production. But you know, the intent of the NFR is really a low sample to give our partners the ability to test, or perhaps even the end customer to kind of get a look and feel about what they're going to, you know, for their endpoints that they want to evaluate as well.
Tommy, thank you so much for answering all those questions for us today. And also thank you to everyone attending. If you have any further questions, of course, please feel free to contact your sales rep or email us at sales@microcomtech.com. And if you wish to view these products mentioned or shown today, please remember this webinar has been recorded and will be uploaded to our Microcom YouTube channel later today, so you can see it all again. Tommy, thank you so much for your time, my friend. And until next time, we'll do this again with the next update that you have to share with us.
Appreciate
Thanks, everybody.
It. Thank you for the time. Thank you, Julie. Bye-bye.
You're all. Welcome.